Game Grumps. I'm not so grump, and we're the Game Grumps.
Hey, welcome back.
Hello again.
To another exciting edition.
Welcome to Kirby and the Rainbow Curse.
Of Game Grumps.
Game Grump. Game Ovar.
My name is Aaron.
And my name is Steve.
That's...
And
no.
Here we are.
Whoa.
Let's do it.
Is this cross promotion between Game Grumps and Two Steves?
Two Steves is not a show.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Finally.
Two Steves.
So, okay, so is this the clay answer to the yarn version of Kirby that we've already played?
So, okay, there's two answers to that. Yes, number one. And number two is this is actually, I don't know if it's a direct sequel, but it's based on a game called Kirby's Canvas Curse, which
Holy
was a
shit.
Nintendo DS launch title.
No way.
With the same gameplay mechanics, so.
I didn't know about any of that.
Yeah, it's crazy. So we're going to play, and you're going to be my Waddle Doo Dee.
What?
Waddle Dee Doo. Waddle Dee.
You better think about what you're saying before you say. Oh, this is adorable.
You know how they do this effect? They animate the characters on a lower frame rate, and they move the camera on a higher frame rate, so it looks like stop motion.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Wow, I had no idea. Doesn't Waddle Dee have a beret?
Yeah, well, he's got like a
little do-rag.
Oh, yeah.
That's great.
Because he's a Waddle Dee on the fringe.
A Waddle do-rag.
Oh, shit!
Hey, oh, man, I hate it when fucking galactic portals open up in my clay sky.
I hate it when the sky turns into a giant asshole.
Embarrassing.
I'm a unicorn shitting out magic. Oh, no, it's sucking in magic.
Oh, no.
Not all the color in the world.
I can't believe that. Oh. Well, this is a fucking downer.
Now there will be no racism.
Because everyone's dead. That's the only way racism's stopping, baby. I hate to break it to you.
Oh, I love these people. Oh, I love the colorful people.
What are they?
Oh, they're awesome. I don't know. They're like cute, though. He looks like a paintbrush.
Oh, have you never seen him before?
No.
Oh.
Dude, this is the first time I've ever even laid eyes upon. Yeah, immediately in love.
Yes, you are.
Oh my god, she's so fucking cute.
I see it in your eyes.
Holy shit. Oh, she painted them colors again!
Oh, and it brings them back to life.
Oh my god.
Wow, those things have fucking eyes in their hands like the goddamn Pale Man from Pan's Labyrinth. Very relaxing. Or are those mouths? I can't tell.
I don't know. They're just sucking mechanic.
Fine, we'll go jerk something off then.
Oh my god, stop.
This is adorable.
Why don't they make an amiibo of this girl? Stop, please. He's like, oh, I will roll
then.
Yeah,
it's all the way over there.
I only roll in going short distances.
I like that they don't even bother to write words for this.
Yeah.
They're just like, map, figure it out.
What if she has like a really long monologue where she tells her past and shit, and they're just all like, oh.
Yeah, coming after on the heels of our Zelda playthrough. With tons of exposition from female non-player characters.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
It's quite a new experience.
All right, so basically what I'm doing is I'm... I guess technically... Bless you. Bless you again.
Thank you.
Gesundheit. I'm technically playing as her and not Kirby.
Really?
Yeah, so I'm drawing lines.
Drawing?
I'm drawing lines on the screen.
Okay.
And Kirby will follow my lines.
Oh.
And then I think you just control like a normal fucking Waddle Dee.
Okay. So I'm like, just kind of riding shotgun
so I can
for
just
this.
Be like, ha-ha!
Whoa!
Yeah, ho! And then I tap him and he dashes. He follows my
this
line.
This is wild!
Yeah. And he fucking, ha-ha! Take that! Take that, you!
Oh, it's...
And then he, oh, shit.
Apparently I'm not available for this level.
It's okay, it's probably the tutorial is just teaching me how to do it.
Okay.
And I'm using a Froakie stylus, by the way. I don't know if you guys are fucking jealous. but you should be.
Yeah. You can't see it, but just imagine it and then experience the true pain of jealousy.
Happy.
Yeah, this is wonderful.
This is some epic
what
yarn
a visually
shit.
Enjoyable game to look at.
Oh, I know. I just want to, like, stick my finger in it and create shapes and such.
Yeah. Is there a way to turn down the volume on my controller?
Yes. Oh my god, that is a loud fucking controller. Hold on, let's do it.
Right.
Let's fuck it. Let's do a little behind the scenes action right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, shh. Don't tell anyone.
Let's do settings for
okay.
your Wiimote.
All
and
right.
We'll just turn it down.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, like that.
That's nice.
That was half volume.
That's crazy. Put it up to full.
Okay. Let's hear what mayhem that controller rots.
Okay.
Here we go. Resume.
Okay. And where am I?
I think you have to come back.
There I am.
How loud is it?
How
do you make sounds?
I gotta do something first. We gotta break through that block.
What do you do? Oh, I don't know how.
I don't know either.
This is our first challenge.
Boy.
Oh god. Oh god. The speaker can't even handle it.
I know.
Alright, I'm gonna have to turn that down.
Alright.
This is maybe like a tad. I don't know.
Just a pinch. Just a pinch. Like an all the way pinch.
Yeah.
Okay, also, look at this cool effect.
Oh yeah. Everything looks like it's made out of clay.
That looks like, that green stuff that disintegrates kind of looks like, that potter's plant bricks that we love so much that you smush down and it, like, never takes its form again. Yeah.
Oh, I love those things.
Me too. Everybody loves them.
Oh, those are the best.
They're the best for the mushing.
I never even knew what those did for, like, till I was 20.
Yeah, well, we talked about them on the show and someone sent Barry and I a brick.
What? Really?
Yeah, and we took it home and fucking beat the shit out of it. Oh my god, like you would not even believe.
Somebody once... Oh, I don't know if I want to tell this story. I'll just do it.
Do it.
Somebody once sent us an aggro crag a long time ago.
An aggro crag?
It was like a replica of the aggro crag. Do you remember the aggro crag?
No.
From Nickelodeon Guts.
Oh, right. Yeah. Right.
So they sent us like a replica one that was made out of foam.
Okay.
And I had it for the longest time. And I didn't have anywhere to put it or anything.
Whoa.
It was just sort of
taking
up space.
Don't like that.
So I went, Jesus, what the hell's going on? Oh no, oh no, oh no!
Yeah, I know, that thing's fucking uncool.
And somebody, so I was just like, man, I guess I'll just throw it away, like, I don't have anything, get out of here! I don't have anything to do with it, like...
Right. Well, you know, it's like my granddad used to say, if you can't eat it or dance with it, fuck it or throw it away. I'm sorry, what were you saying?
Fuck it or throw it away?
Yeah, go on with your story.
So I went to go out and throw it away, but there's, like, this kid who hangs out in front of my house because, like, he walks all the way from school to that specific spot for some reason on my sidewalk to, like, wait for his mom.
Okay.
And, like, he was out there when I was throwing it away. And then for some reason I got this idea where I was like, you know what, I'm gonna invite this kid to come and, like, beat the shit out of this aggro crag with me.
Right.
So I was like, hey man, do you wanna, like... I'm gonna come over here and beat the shit out of this aggro crag, and he was- and he just had, like, this look on his face, like, I would like nothing more than to do that. And then we just kicked the shit out of this piece of aggro, and it was, like, one of the best moments of my life.
Why wouldn't you want to tell that story?
Because somebody sent it to me, and I didn't want to seem like I was being disrespectful.
They
to
sent
stuff.
It to you so you could get joy out of it, and you got lots of joy
I
out
sure
of it.
Did. I yeah. sure did. And so did that kid.
Yeah, so that's
I'll,
what it's
I'll
all about.
I'll never see him again.
I just laid you up like a basketball.
Oh, man, you helped me. Whoa. Layup!
Nice.
I hope he... Have you ever heard that song?
What?
I hope he cheat on you like a basketball player.
Oh, no.
It's like the funniest one.
It sounds really
It's actually
smart.
Like a really catchy song, too. Uh-huh. Which makes it like... It's like a guilty pleasure. I hope he cheat on you like a basketball player. you Kim Kardashian, your way up. You ever heard that song?
I have never heard it. It sounds really good.
I forgot who sings it. But, oh man, you should.
Whoever they are. Crazy fucking talented.
I should let you listen to that song, because, man, it was my favorite for a while.
Yeah?
Like, unironically.
Yeah, I think we just squeaked by there.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know.
I like that, my fucking spear of death has a little red bow tied around it.
I also like...
I think that's a cute... It's a cute... I'm gonna do that with all my fucking medieval weaponry from
yeah,
now.
Yeah, just like your death... You put a little eyeshadow on your, Iron Maiden.
That sounds good. Sounds really good.
Oh my god, I got a figure of the cute girl!
Oh.
Oh, they never talk, so I don't know her name.
Whoa.
It's the first thing I would ask.
Yeah, I bet it's online.
Oh, yeah, you got Wikipedia. Who's the colored hair girl?
Yeah.
And it's one of those things where Google, like, actually has a response.
Yeah.
Oh, we can now use Amiibo.
The colored girl that you want to have sex with is... Oh, I shouldn't say colored girl. The girl with the colored... Ah, fuck it. You know what? Forget the whole thing.
Now we can use Amiibo, and I have day-to-day, DDD, and Kirby, but I don't have them opened because I like to keep them in the packages.
Okay.
All my opened amiibos are at home, so I guess we're not going to be able to use them.
That's okay.
But if we come back to this next time, I'll bring them. And
will
then
you
we
really?
Can use amiibos, yeah.
All right. Let's do that.
So it'll be fun. We'll play some motherfucking amiibo shits, super bonus amiibos.
Going up the big old tree.
Yeah, everything's a colloquialism.
Yeah.
Shit, man. Big old tree, yo. Like, that's the name of the stage. Dang.
Grandpappy's pecans. Just like, no explanation.
I don't want to speak for Markiplier or anything, but he has told me on many occasions that Cracker Barrel is his absolute favorite restaurant.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
In that case, I want to go with it, with him.
I know, don't
why.
You, like, right? Like, even if somebody was, like, if somewhere you've been, like, a million times, and it's like, oh, fucking McDonald's. But if someone's like, dude, McDonald's is my number one favorite restaurant. You'd be like, dude, I want to party with you there.
Yeah, what?
Let's fucking go. I'm down.
Yeah, fine.
Like, what's good there?
Yeah, explain, what does McDonald's even have? I have not honestly been inside a McDonald's in almost 15 years
now. That is absolutely to your benefit.
Yeah, I know.
I can say without a doubt.
Yeah. It's coincidental, because 15 years is the amount of years I've added onto the end of my life by not eating.
Oh, man. Sick McDonald's burn, bro.
Yeah, well, they burn themselves.
I guess we'll never get a McDonald's brand deal.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Not that I would ever, really ever want one. But McDonald's, if you're ever looking, yeah. Count to the Game Grumps.
You've got $3 million, or even $20, burning a hole in your pockets.
$20.
Yeah, I'd do a $20 brand deal for McDonald's.
Oh,
are you kidding
me? Oh, my God.
Have we talked about that on the show yet?
No, we haven't.
Jesus.
You just, like, let me listen to it one time when we were playing Bloodborne,
yeah.
And then that was that.
People should listen to Brent Weinbach, Weinbach, the Russian alphabet. Not the live version, like the fucking weird, like, studio version with him wearing a shirt of himself.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And that's all you need to know. Don't ask any more questions than that.
Yeah.
Just listen to it.
I think that's exactly how it's supposed to be presented.
And then check back tomorrow as we fucking repeat that shit almost word for word. It was a kids show with renowned stage actor Ben Vereen as the,
What the fuck is Ben? What is a Ben Vereen?
Ben Vereen. It's a human being, not a thing.
I don't believe you.
Yeah. Do you remember Pinky and the Brain? Like, his thing? Like, Charlie Sheen, Ben Vereen turned me the size of a lima bean, and then he gets small?
What?
God fucking damn it!
No.
Guess I shouldn't have made an 80s reference and then tried to justify it with a 90s reference.
That's true. Yeah, you need to do it with, like, maybe, like, a mid-2014 reference. Yeah. That'll probably...
Yeah.
That'll
what are the kids
good.
Like these days?
Ben Vereen, huh?
Boy, I sure love, broccoli. Fuck.
Yeah. Damn, dude, we got fucking music.
Yeah, we got figurines for days.
That's crazy.
The music room is open.
Then listen to them all again. And again.
Maybe I fucking will. Just get way too sassy with the Kirby game.
Fine! Just, like, crank up your boombox.
Yeah.
And I don't even care if it's loud! Ooh, new challenge mode.
Vega comes in. Shink!
It's just, like, way too real for Kirby World. They should just have a level in Kirby that's just, like, aliens. Like,
yeah.
The movie Aliens.
Oh, absolutely.
Like, everything's really disgusting and,
yeah.
Like...
Oh. H.R. Giger, like, the xenomorph comes and just fucking blasts his second gross mouth through Waddle Dee's face.
Hi!
It's like... Whoa.
Oh, that'd be great.
Watch out for... I can tell by his briefly angry eyebrows that he's someone we should be stabbing.
You stab, I just roll.
Yeah. Actually, that's not a statement I should ever take out of context. Didn't like his face! Stabbed him.
I knew by the way he looked at me.
Yeah. He was ripe for the stabbing.
Man, I love stabbing.
Whew. Don't even get me started. How delightful this stabbing is.
Don't even get me started on talking about stabbing and the stabbing action itself.
L is for elephantitis. Don't even get me started.
Oh, man.
Jesus, Brent Weinbach, you're a fucking genius.
This is one of the funniest things I've ever seen.
It really is. Especially when you start playing it for someone with absolutely no context or warning.
That's exactly what I did with Barry.
Yeah, did he like it?
Yeah.
Okay, killer.
laughed at all the same spots.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, that's a good sign.
It's so fucking funny.
Fucking elephantitis, don't even get me started. Made me laugh so hard.
S is for psycho. Ouch.
Why is that funny?
I don't know. I don't know. It just is.
Because there's something weirdly unintuitive about drawing lines.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. To steer Kirby.
You mean, is there a speedrunner for this who, like, is just a fucking master artist?
Yeah. I feel like it's two different skills, though.
Maybe.
Because it has to do with your, like, sense of pathfinding.
He's, like, dropping Mona Lisas and shit.
Whoa!
Yeah, Leonardo da Vinci's like, fuck this game!
Yeah.
This is not at all what it's like.
Impossible. Also, why am I alive?
Yeah.
What is this?
Well, if there was one person I'd bring back, it'd probably be Leonardo da Vinci.
Wait, is that right?
Yeah. So I could be like, hey, bro, paint me something. Paint me. Paint me. I'll give you a dollar.
I'd bring back Hitler so I could whoop his ass and impress chicks. I'd do anything for you, ladies? Yeah, I'd beat the shit out of Hitler. What about it?
I would bring back, I don't know, Quasimodo.
He was not real.
So I could be like his, he's like
he
my wingman.
Yeah, oh yeah, sure.
You know?
Looking better by comparison.
Yeah.
Classic move.
What if there was a letter that was just like an entire phrase?
Isn't that what kanji is?
Well, I guess so. Huh.
Yeah, I just blow your mind with shit that you already knew.
God damn it. Dan, stop being so smart, you big goof.
Sorry. I can't help it!
I went to school! My teacher said I was special!
Just don't let the comedy seep out!
Oh my god.
Oh, so adorable.
That shit made me laugh so hard.
I know, it was the funniest. We must have told that, right?
No, I don't think we ever did.
We took an improv class
with
our awesome teacher, Julia, and, like, she, at the beginning of every class, there was this doorway that had, like, loud shit always happening on the other side of it. So we kept the door closed, but it was too hot. So she opened it up. We were like, can we please open the door? She was like, all right, just don't let the comedy seep out. We were like, Julia, you're fucking lovely as shit.
I asked her if I could, like, watch her perform or something.
Uh-huh.
I was like, do you do shows? And she was like, I'm not good enough for shows. And I was
really?
Like, oh, come on.
That's crazy, Tom.
Yeah.
Wait, you're good enough to teach, but not good enough to do a show?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's, you know, it's different, like, being on your feet versus...
I guess.
...knowing the rules.
But still.
I could say I understand that. But yeah, I was like, man, you're, like, really funny. I wanna...
Yeah.
...actually see...
I have to draw
what
you.
...what the situation is. That was really weird, though, too, because, like, it was all of us.
Right.
And then, like, a couple other people.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, we knew each other. And so we sort of, like, laughed harder out of, like, support and also because we sort of know each other's personalities.
Right.
Whereas, like, when someone else would go up, it was just like...
Yeah, the five people who enrolled in the class that didn't know the group of nine of us that signed up. Yeah, they had a little bit more of a difficult time being like, what the fuck?
Why is that funny? That makes no sense.
Yeah. And we're like, trust us, this time one thing happened.
Yeah. We do an internet show.
It was fun, though. It was a fun trip.
Yeah, agreed.
Groundlings, baby. Groundlings is a good school for improv comedy.
Did it.
That actually is really cool. A little Rube Goldberg action.
Yeah. I hope it gets to that point.
Yeah, where
it starts playing. You know that song?
Yeah, I know it.
How do I get there?
It has to do with
ball.
This ball, right?
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
And the ball goes that way. That way. Oh, it's getting a little Rube Goldberg-y.
Yeah.
I'm assuming it's called that because the guy who invented the concept was named Rube Goldberg.
Yeah, I doubt. I just wanted to pay homage to my Jewish uncle.
But so what was the original Rube Goldberg machine?
I don't know. That's worth looking up.
Was it just like a really simple one where it was like a dude and then he's like, hit that button and then
it's one guy pressing one button.
Yeah.
Check out this Rube Goldberg contraption. Like his name was Rube Goldberg. Well, now we know. Now we know where it comes from. Great.
I could have pressed it myself, but I made a guy do it.
Yeah. Makes sense.
That's a very complicated contraption.
You mess with the ball, you get the Breakfast Club reference.
That's true, actually.
Yeah. My favorite character is John Bender because he's smart, but he also is a criminal. And that's sort of how I feel inside, you know, like...
I can kind of identify with that.
I'm misunderstood, but I'm also very wise for my age.
Don't fuck this up. You did it. You fucked it up.
Isn't it weird how John Bender was the voice of reason and he was the criminal?
Who played him? Judd Nelson?
Yes.
I guess that is weird.
I think that's the whole point, though.
Yeah. Look at us. We're a fucking rebel. An artist. A lover. Ranger? Wizard? And acrobat.
Acrobat!
Thief!
And then he's like, what? And they're like, get him!
Oh, goodness. You know, we just kind of... What is happening right now?
The cutest thing.
It just really fucking came home to me. I think I'll sit this one out.
Oh my fucking god, stop. I'm a slow Kirby tank and it's playing
green greens. You do little flippies.
In like a tiny, understated piccolo.
Jesus Christmas.
Oh, you're back,
yep.
I think.
Yeah, I'm just for the transitional phase.
Still a tank.
And I'm just holding a cannon.
Oh my god, you have a cannon too?
Yes.
Dude, we're tank buddies.
You finally. And I don't mean we're just wearing the same shirts.
But to me, it doesn't matter.
D is for these nuts.
Look, I don't give a shit.
Listen, you guys better watch The Russian Alphabet by Brent Weinbach, the studio version, or you're just not gonna know what the fuck we're talking about time in this playthrough.
Yeah, it was literally zero.
Sorry about that.
It's Garfield. Like, that's Garfield, is it not?
He must be smiling because it's not a Monday.
That would be awesome if this episode aired on a Monday.
Oh, boy.
It's not a Monday. Oh,
Mondays. Someone found lasagna in the ancient temple.
Looks like Odie took the day off.
Boy, Garfield is ridiculous. And I died again.
Garfield is the funniest thing on the planet. And
is
not
it?
And ironically, completely ironically. I don't think I've ever found a single actual Garfield comic funny.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I thought, well, I don't know. I used to think Garfield was funny, but it might just be because I compared it to Heathcliff, which was literally the most unfunny thing in the world.
I don't remember anything from Heathcliff except that he looks dumb.
Yeah. He was just an ugly character. In a doofy show.
A doofy show.
He did have a friend I liked called Wordsworth, who was like a cat poet, and he had funky hair.
Oh, shit.
Do you remember him? He was like white, I think.
Sounds kind of familiar.
Yeah. I think you talk like this. Oh.
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 Well, that's because the camera
got it.
You know, yes. I was holding out for that three up, but yeah, it's no big
Woo,
deal.
Baby.
It's no big deal if you want to
That's right.
circumvent all of the
stars
good plans
collected.
That
607.
I had.
You know how much it would have been without that last star? 607. Sorry to answer my own question.
I think collecting stars actually gives you one ups, so you just basically did 1% of, or no, you did 0.03%
yeah.
of what I was trying to do.
You're welcome.
0.33 repeating percent.
I said you're welcome. You don't have to keep flattering me.
Oh, cool. Yay, I got trophies.
Oh, sweet. You
I
got
mean,
figurines.
We got trophies.
Oh, thank you, Aaron. Thank you for including me.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Where do those go?
Into a collection that has nothing to do with what we're doing.
Okay.
It's just sort of for dudes, weirdos like myself, who are like, I must have this.
Yeah, I understand.
Oh shit, I didn't bring my amiibos in today.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just still the last session that we played, and I still don't have the amiibos.
I know, crazy, right?
Ugh, man.
Well, you got that one at E3 that you were super happy about.
Oh my, well that was an amiibo, that was a Skylander.
Oh, Skylander, that's what I meant, yeah.
Bro, if those wonderful people at Nintendo didn't tell me about that, I would have never known.
That was really nice of them.
It was. I was playing Skylanders at the Nintendo booth, and the dude was like, you know, if you go to the Activision booth, they have a special Skylander. And I was like, what?
And you were like, what the fuck am I doing talking to you right now?
Yeah. I hate you! The only reason you're redeeming to me is because you gave me this information.
Yeah, exactly. And now that time has passed. So, adieu, my friend.
I've gone back to my default state of hating you. So, thank you.
Oh, man. What if your default state was just hate?
I'm pretty sure there are a lot of
plenty of people.
YouTube channels where that is the case.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, welcome back to Game Grumps.
Hey. It's like hey with a period.
Aaron was just telling
hey
me
with another period.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
No, you were just telling me more about your fucking Apple Watch that fucking you can't stop talking about. You just keep yawning and like outstretching that arm. Like, oh gosh, what time is it?
It's funny because I'm like. Like 90% of it is me doing it facetiously.
Oh, of course. Of course.
And then there's like the other 10% where
that
I actually
totally
am
real.
Excited about
it's
it.
Totally real. You and Mark, who also got one, Mr. Applier, like shocking how into it you guys are.
Oh, yeah.
Especially when you get into the same room with each other and you're like,
oh, we can send each other our heartbeats. Yeah. Yes, it will track your heartbeat and then send it to another person. I don't know the functionality of this.
No, I don't know.
There's no point to it.
It's to show love.
One of the most useless things. Even in a situation where it's like, I'll send it to my wife.
Yeah.
It's like, what the fuck does she give a shit about?
It's primarily...
It just goes boop, 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 and that's it.
Yeah, like a heart. Like, I think almost all of the functions between two Apple Watches... Like, the main functionality is to just make everyone who does not have an Apple Watch in the room feel excluded and feel the need to purchase an Apple Watch.
I think that, you know what, I think you're right.
Yeah.
I think that was actually the design philosophy behind Apple Watch to Apple Watch functionality.
There's no question in my mind, because, boy, I've never seen anything turn people into such immediate douchebags as the Apple Watch.
Oh man, I've gotten to the point too where it's like, I'm totally trying to avoid all the like douche tropes.
Right.
And I had this moment where I was like at this, I was at a store and the clerk was like, "Hey, nice watch," and I was just like,
"Thanks, it's mine and mine alone."
No, I was just like, "Thanks," and then like that's it.
Right.
Because
right.
I was trying to assess the situation of whether or not they were like actually like they knew what it was and they were like wanted to know more.
Sure.
But I was just like, nope, you know what? I'm just gonna let this ride. I'm just not gonna
Thanks,
even...
it's the hottest new thing in technology. I'm glad you noticed.
That was...
I mean, really, it's more of a status symbol than anything.
Yeah, honestly.
God, you must feel inferior.
I almost got the gold one.
Yeah.
Did you know that they'll switch out the innards for you? Because it's so awesome that it's gold, that if there's a new Apple Watch, you can just send it in, and they'll totally, like, I mean, yeah. I don't mean to brag or anything, but I almost got it. I almost got it.
Yeah. I decided, like, I only want too much money today. As opposed to obscene amounts of money.
Oh, boy.
It's pretty wonderful.
It's not worth it. I just want to say right now, the Apple Watch is not worth it? No.
You talk about it more than any other thing.
Well, that's because I have it now.
Right. And it's worth it.
It's not worth it.
Wait,
it's
why?
It's so expensive.
Oh.
It's like, it's absurdly expensive for what it is. Which is essentially an extension of functionality you already have.
As in, like, an iPhone on your wrist?
Yes. You could- oh, fuck. You could tape your phone to your wrist and it would have the same functionality as the fucking Apple Watch. Wait, what the fuck?
I've watched episodes back with us, where, like, we get distracted during a story. And it just happens sometimes. Yeah, I see it. You can fucking- aim your torpedoes.
Yeah, I'm listening though.
Yeah, I bet. So, like, I've watched episodes back of us where, like, we get distracted, and it's hard sometimes because, like, you know, you're also concentrating on a video game. So, like, when the subject changes, it's hard to get things back.
Oh, dude, I've gotten emails from people that are like,
oh, yeah.
What was the story? It was so interesting what you were saying.
Yeah.
Have to know.
And like, I'll get those messages too, and I'll look back and I'll try to remember, and like, I'll see where I get distracted in the episode, and I'm like, God damn it. Like, I have no idea.
Yeah, there's no clue what
we'll
I was
going to say. We'll never know.
I think 9 times out of 10, that's the case.
Yeah.
Is I'm just like, I don't even remember.
Yeah. But you have to assume that it probably wasn't as cool as you think it might have been.
Yeah.
Like, my God. I've needed, the cuddles of a living creature this month so goddamn badly. Like, there have been so many times where I've thought, like, oh, if I had a fucking dog. But, I guess I just have to fucking watch, the episode of our Teletubbies playthrough where those little girls fucking run with that dog through the park and make him drink gasoline. That's the closest I can get.
I made him drink gasoline.
Make him go faster. Oh, God. That's one of my, it's one of my all-time favorites.
All-time faves.
Yeah.
For
yeah.
sure.
That was a really good one. Ooh. Did we ever find out if, the Teletubbies comment that was on that was an actual, was official Teletubbies?
Yeah, it was absolutely official Teletubbies.
Like, did they watch the episode, do you think? Or did they just, see that we played it and said thank you?
I don't know. I sometimes wonder about, stuff like that.
We talked a lot of shit on the Teletubbies for them to be like, thanks for playing.
Maybe they're just trying to, do the good guy approach.
We called them soulless monsters. In no uncertain terms.
It's no wonder you turned out so mellow and nice.
Thank you, Aaron. I mean, you could have said, well-read and learned and understanding, but, I guess nice is cool, too.
What's wrong with nice?
Well, that's what you call an ugly person. He's very nice.
No, Dan, he's nice.
He's so...
Yeah, it's only if... it's only.
But is he good looking? Should I introduce my girlfriends to him? He's really nice.
Yeah.
Oh, that's rough.
Yeah, that was like an old, that was an old bit I was gonna do for, when I worked at Fox. It was like an old short I was gonna do.
Right.
It was like a old man telling an adventurer, about the journey he's about to go on. And he's just like, you must find the key and save for the sword and the magic wisdom. And he's like, that sounds great. And he's like, yes, it's a great adventure. It's very treacherous and dangerous, but you will find great blah, blah, blah. And he's like, oh, awesome. And then he's like, and at the very, there's a princess that you must save as a kingdom. And then he's like, is she hot? He's like, and then that was just the end of the bit.
That guy kind of looks like Rick from Rick and Morty.
What? The guy in the back?
No. The spiky-headed thing. I'll show
that?
Him. If you look to the side, their eyes and a mouth.
Morty, what are you doing, Morty? Oh, you killed the Simpsons, Morty. What are you doing? Oh, no. Oh, look at the baby one.
Outstanding.
I'm underwater, Morty. Oh, I'm underwater. I can't breathe. it's too much for me to handle. Oh, jeez. All these bubbles coming out. That just implies that I can't breathe anymore.
Well, because the ones where we're burned out end up being some of the better ones.
Oh, yeah, like Yoshi's Cookie.
Oh, God, and the fucking Pass the Mustard Batman from Pokemon. I still fucking think about that.
Pass the Mustard Batman.
I can't Batman. Make a move, but he needs that mustard.
He really needs that mustard. Yeah, that was it. I'm glad that you can get your potty humor shit out on Game Grumps, because I remember we just recently had the conversation where you were staying away from that for like NSP, and I guess to some extent Starbomb.
Oh, well, I mean, we've never done like toilet humor on NSP.
Yeah, because I was like, we should make a song about like poopy or something. Yeah, and you were like, nah.
it just never comes out as funny as you think it will.
Yeah.
You know? Like, I mean, God knows we make a lot of poop jokes on Game Grumps, but like, something about it. If you're gonna make something that's like really enduring, you know, like, I hope people are still listening to Ninja Sex Party in like 20 years.
Yeah.
And maybe that's wildly optimistic, but I'd like those jokes to still be funny then, you know? Which sure. is why we've never done anything like topical, you know?
We're always gonna pee and poo, Dan. Like, what the fuck are you talking about?
I stand wildly corrected. That's absolutely true.
Like, that's the one thing that you can absolutely count
on. Take to the bank, yeah.
Is that we're definitely going to still be peeing and pooping in 20 years.
Fuck! Stop fucking dying, Aaron. I was just about to say it, too, because I was like, he's fucking toddling awfully close to the bottom of the screen.
I was trying to preserve my rainbow because I was running out.
I'm going to scissor kick your Johnson. Specifically the Johnson region.
But I'm saying, like, you know, it's like, all right, fucking... FYI, I want to F your A. Maybe we won't have acronyms. That's a pretty social thing. Like, in 20 years, we might just abandon acronyms.
Do you really think so? I have a feeling that in 20 years, everything will be acronyms.
But. said but.
Yeah, you did. Awesome.
But. You're always going to have a but. You're always going to go pee-pee.
You know what, Aaron?
Unless somebody invents
That's a really
like a
salient point you just made.
So why not embrace it, bro?
Yeah, you're right. I've been a fool.
I've been a fool to have standards my whole life.
Yeah, yeah. Stay tuned for NSP's fourth album, Shitting in the Shithouse.
Pee-pee poo-poo town.
Pee-pee poo-poo town.
Starring poo-poo and the pee-pets.
I thought you were talking about like the little flip shades that Dwayne from A Different World used to wear.
Those are words that I've never heard before.
It's a 1991 reference. I didn't really expect it to connect.
I was four?
After... Whoa, really?
Yeah.
Oh, geez. We shouldn't talk about those days.
When I was four?
The days when our age gap, like, really, really mattered.
Well, there's probably, like, you know, I'm not gonna...
In 1991, I was in sixth grade.
Wow. I wasn't in grade.
Yeah. Meanwhile, I could have been walking around the schoolyard of my grade school just being like, hey, you guys see that little kid? Yeah, he's not in nursery school yet. He's gonna be my best friend one day. Jealous?
What do you guys think?
Yeah, that's right.
We're gonna be like super happy and like living in places that we like and like, yeah, it's gonna be awesome.
See you later, losers.
Idiots.
Yeah. I'm gonna go eat mashed peas with him.
I don't even know what I was doing when I was four.
I am unclear. Four is definitely the first time I have, like, memories that I can remember.
Yeah, oh god.
So I think...
Yikes.
Whoa, okay, that
yeah,
got
I don't even
real
know
serious.
What's going on.
I think, well, because my older nephew, Nash, he's four now. And so, like, I have to keep that in mind. I'm like, oh man, he's at that age where, like, he might actually remember what's going on and what I say to him. So I better stop, like, lying to him directly about Superman living in my house and stuff like that. Because he is going to be really...
Are you doing that just
really
like,
annoying.
As a joke to yourself?
Well, I mean, yeah, to a degree, but also because I love seeing, like, the excitement on his face.
Hey, look at you. You're sleeping on the end of my rainbow. That's Aww. Nice and cute and adorable and, like, kind of sad that you died, but whatever. But you come back to life.
Whatever. Here's some edamame.
Mmm.
Yeah.
Peapod.
Peapod. By the way, like, I like the term sleeping on the end of my rainbow. It just feels like it should mean something else.
Sleeping on the end of my rainbow. Like when you get into like a heated argument with like a clerk or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
At a Dairy Queen or
Go
like
on.
A Frito-Lay shop.
I'm with you.
You're like, look, I'm sleeping at the end of my rainbow here. And you do not want to see me once that rainbow ends up losing ink.
Ink?
Yeah, because this is like ink brush.
Oh, sure. You gotta follow the path, Aaron.
You gotta follow the path, because if you wizardy don't...
Where are you going?
You
We've only got 38 seconds, Aaron.
You wizardy won't get to the end.
You're wasting my goddamn time. We're 30 seconds.
How much do you think it costs to buy a doggy in this economy? $30, 40 cents.
You're probably right.
It's probably a whole amount of money that I've never heard of. Rupees! That's a different country's currency.
Rupees! Like it's unrelated to money. He's just talking about, like, what should I eat for dinner tonight? Boy, there's nothing like a... Rupees!
Chef Boyard!
Dude, 13 seconds. Get to the exit.
Oh, my God. I don't... Do I have...
You're the other way, shit stain.
Did I get all the things?
No, it doesn't matter. Just get out of here.
No, it does matter. The door was not open.
You're gonna blow up.
Bang. The door is open.
You did it.
Oh my God, but I don't want that.
Aaron.
I want this.
Well, you greedy bitch. You just doomed us all. Just fucking doomed us all. Yay, we made it.
At least I tried.
Never doubted you.
My true friend.
You've killed us all.
I'm sorry if anybody in our audience has SARS.
Yeah, I'm SARSy.
We could not make that joke about any other fucking horrible disease.
Yeah, okay, all right.
Except SARS, yeah. Nobody has it.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure nobody has it.
Like, if we started making, like, AIDS jokes, then it would just be like,
it wouldn't be cool.
Not cool. Not as cool as SARS jokes.
Not as cool as SARS jokes. Don't even get me started on swine flu, which is the hippest of all fucking earthly maladies. Orange Woodland.
Orange Woodland?
Mm-hmm. The Woodland Battle. Oh my gosh.
That sounds so intense.
It's so
in this really gentle-looking world. There's just mushrooms and tree stumps.
Dumps.
Like somewhere that would be really nice to read a book and drink tea.
Oh, that does sound delightful, actually.
And get this cherry.
Get that cherry dough.
Cherry air.
Oh, is that your new flavored drink?
If you have a red butt, it's a cherry air.
It's a cherry.
Like a baboon or something.
That's ridiculous.
Hey, I'm a little tank again.
You just reminded me of an idea I had for a grump out thing.
Yeah.
Oh man, maybe I shouldn't say it on the show. I don't want to ruin the surprise. But we'll probably never do it, because we always forget. It's called, Seventh Kevin. And it's just, like, Kevin dancing, but, like, seven of him. To whatever music we want.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I'm down with it.
It's gotta be something from Incompetech.
Yeah, seven Kevins in heaven. We could, like, there's...
Seven Kevins in heaven.
Yeah, there's no end of the glory that we could create with this.
Oh boy. Oh, Kev.
Yeah, you're our sweet bamboo, Kevin. We love you.
I was gonna say something about Kevin, as if he wasn't listening.
Yeah, he's, in fact, right now, the only one listening.
Like, as if this wasn't going out publicly
yeah.
to, like, a zillion people.
Like, we just sold, like we don't even put out Game Grumps, we just, like, tell Kevin lies so he'll feel, like, useful in his job. Yeah, dude, edit the show. A lot of people are gonna watch.
Yeah, and we, like, pay for the views. Just yeah.
It's all a bot.
Just to add to the facade. It's really a private account.
Oh, God. It's just, like, my dad refreshing constantly 1 million times.
Why do you want me to do this, yeah. then?
Hey, Kevin better appreciate this!
Don't worry, Father.
Yeah.
Have you ever called your dad Father?
Only jokingly.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll be like,
Father?
Yeah.
He's like, what?
Please fetch me the water barrel.
Yeah. Father, would you hold my tallywhacker while I pass water? Okay.
I love how Kirby, like, he rolls like a real ball, so, like... He can't really have any bearings of, like, where he is.
That's a good point, damn it, Aaron.
I'm sorry, I thought it was gonna turn.
We've already established we don't need to, like, fucking go for it like it's a Vegas game. We can just stand underneath and go, bip.
That's true, I forgot.
All of my money on black.
I just like the idea that if Kirby had to, like, recall that, like, after he beats the game and he has to recall, like, his adventures and... Canvas Rainbow Curse Town.
Yes.
It's just like, I don't, like, do you really think I remembered any of this shit? I was fucking rolling around like crazy the whole time.
That's a good point.
Just getting mad anxiety and barfy.
My equilibrium is fucked.
And he's like, yay, this is the only time I can sense the world around me.
Oh, okay, gondola ride. I'm just,
that'll be nice and relaxing. Yay!
Just knocks the dude with the violin off the fucking gondola.
Senor!
Senor! Oh, can't give that top secret thing away.
Oh, shit, no. You're as good as bad could get.
It's true. Yeah, you know that bonus claim your prize section at the end of the level? Yeah. I've almost got that totally down.
I've almost gotten to the point where people could say that I'm not bad at it.
Yeah. It's gonna happen.
Well, I got a figurine. Oh, he's cute. Look
at
that.
He's on the little thing.
Oh, he's the electric guy. He was a pain in the ass.
Yeah, fuck him.
Can I just, like, squish him?
Yeah, he's...
Can I get one of those Play-Doh stamps where you just, like, and then it says, like, splat on it?
Nothing... No, there's no one in the world that has, like, a gross splatting sound more than you do. Like, that I enjoy, personally.
Oh, really?
Like, the... I can't even do it. Can you
gotta, like, make a really wet fart sound.
Can you give me one?
Just, like... That?
That's the one!
I learned it from what's-his-face, Mouth Sounds Guy.
Mouth Sounds Guy?
Yeah, I think I talked about it on an episode a long time ago. Okay. There was a dude who, like, made mouth sounds, and he, like, wrote a book on how to do mouth sounds, but it was a book.
Yeah, that's awfully, like, tough to...
Yeah, so he's like, elongate your throat, and then, put your lips in an O shape, but not too much of an O that it becomes, and it's like, what the fuck?
Yeah, that's really esoteric.
And then blow, and it's like, okay. Is that how you do it?
Yeah,
is that him
have,
a duck
have I got
quack?
It down? Competitive whistling, am I ready?
Yeah, that was, I remember specifically, like, there was one sound I wanted to make. It was like the sound of a banjo or something. And it was exactly like that. It was just like, put your this and that. It's completely fucking, what the hell does that mean? And then I was like, I can't make the banjo sound. I'm a failure. And I felt so bad.
Yeah. Meanwhile, if he was just in the room with you, he'd just be like, do like this, like, ba-da-ding, you know. Done.
Bling, 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 bling. It's like that.
Oh, dude. If you and I did like a competitive mouth version of dueling banjos, make me really happy.
Bing, 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 bing.
It's a... And then they get assaulted in a fucking... what's that movie?
Deliverance?
That's the one.
That's the movie, right?
Yes, it is.
That's the one where it's like the weird guy on the... On the ledge or whatever.
Yeah. He's like, I'm gonna make you squeal like a pig, boy.
Is that movie good?
Yeah, it's very disturbing.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know if I,
I know it's one of those, like, it's
I don't know if I
down.
Described it in a happy enough way. My friend is super into zombies, and he, like, continually believes there's going to be a zombie apocalypse. And I'm like, you know they're not real, right? And he's like, well, you'll be sorry when the apocalypse starts. And I'm like, the apocalypse caused by the things that are not real? Is that the one I'm waiting for?
That's actually not true.
Oh?
There are accounts, real scientific accounts of zombies.
Oh, dear.
It was like a country, either an African or a South American country or something.
Mm-hmm.
But basically, like, there was something about their diet or, like, some drug that's really popular there.
Mm-hmm.
That, like, when it gets mixed with, like, people who have, like, freshly died, it'll, like, sort of wake them up.
What?
Yeah. I mean, they're not, like, brains or anything, but, like, they totally will, like, I think some accounts have them, like, walking around.
How is there not, like, how has that never come to America then? Because, like, all those people, like, freezing themselves, like, don't you think they'd want to be like, yeah, I'd like to come back for, like, 30 seconds, even if it's 30 seconds?
Yeah. Well, I don't think they're, like, I think it's just, like,
they're
stimuli.
Not like,
you know?
Oh, okay, they're not cognizant of, like, yeah. They're aware. Oh, okay. Fair enough.
I'll have to look that up, because I don't remember the specific details of it, but, like, yeah. It was, like, near death or completely dead people, like, they come back for
Whoa.
A little bit.
I have to say, probably our darkest Kirby episode ever.
Well, we went from zombies to real zombies.
Yeah, yeah, and I mean, but we also talked about Deliverance and the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. You just reminded me. I used to have the CD single of that song back
really?
In 1991.
Was it? It was the EP.
No, just the
just the single.
Yeah, just the song and the B side. And
what was the B side?
I can't. You think I fucking remember the Life and the Highway cassette B side? Oh no, it was CD. It was CD. Mine like had a scratch in it, and it used to skip like right at that gimme thing. Yeah. So it'd be like, I wanna ride it all night long. Gimme, 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 gimme on! What is that noise?
Gimme, 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 gimme.
It like would never get to the, yeah!
Okay.
So, like, I never read fucking comments, but, like, sometimes my friends will send them to me if it makes them laugh.
Uh-huh.
And one was, I was just waiting for Dan to fucking say monkey instead of Waddle Dee. And lo and behold, 30 seconds into episode one, and then just like two paragraphs of like the fundamental differences between the two species. Oh, it was awesome.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, yeah. So thank you.
The
thank
two
you.
Species of fictional and non-fictional characters.
Yeah, I can't stress that enough.
Yeah.
That's actually one of the differences that was highlighted.
Like, that wasn't just me, that was really funny.
No, it was. I just, like, stared in stunned disbelief.
I mean, it's obviously what the game wanted me to do. Don't press this button.
Oh, man.
Immediately and deliberately press the button.
It just speaks to the very inner nature of us as, like, big kids in adult bodies. It's like, oh, really, fool? I'll touch it wherever I want. Okay.
Okay, cool.
That seems like a super easy path to follow.
Because
the there's no time to waste.
Yeah, the yum-to-dump ratio on Taco Bell.
The yum-to-dump.
Yeah, the yum-to-dump ratio.
I've never heard that.
Oh, dude.
Heard of the Y-to-D?
Yeah, the Y-to-D. How'd you know?
Well,
that's what we call it, the Y-to-D.
I've never heard about this.
Wow. Oh, it's a Susie and me thing.
Oh.
Yeah.
There's a... For considering how illegal public urination is here, it happens a lot.
I had a friend who, I used to go to a lot of cons before I, before I got recognized a whole lot of cons.
Uh-huh. Careful.
I was a con goer.
No.
And I had a friend who I would always run into at cons, and he was sort of like the aloof, like, con goer guy, and I was like, oh man, I hope I see this guy. And then I always did, and he always said that he would drop a deuce at a con, and I was like, oh my god, that's amazing, because
that's not amazing.
No, because I thought, my first inclination, and I don't know why it was that he would just, like, get into a corner and just, like, shit somewhere.
Oh.
But then I found out, like, 3 years after I had been, like, so entranced by this concept... That, no, he just goes into a bathroom and takes a shit.
Yeah, that's what I would have assumed he meant.
Well, it's because, like, why is that special? I think that's why...
It's not special. He was, like, a socially awkward person.
It's a tradition to rip a deuce every time... Fuck! It's a tradition to drop a deuce every time I come to a con, and it's like, well, yeah, it's a tradition for me, too, because I poop frequently.
Right, right.
So, that's not a tradition, that's just a thing.
Yeah, it's just pooping.
So, I was like... I was heartbroken.
Heartbroken, Aaron?
I was so upset.
So far, you've used... the two adjectives you've used to describe this story are heartbroken and amazing.
Oh, damn. Oh, damn. It's all you, bro.
Hold on.
This is all you.
Stand back.
Three up, baby.
Boom.
I'm gonna take a sip of my, sugary beverage.
Your Pepsi?
Mmm.
Bonsoir.
I don't want to give any brand loyalty, but it is a sugary beverage.
Yeah.
Of the cola variety.
Yeah. And it rhymes with everybody's favorite disease, Hep C.
Well, first of all, not my favorite disease, personally. Maybe number 3.
Yeah. Definitely top 10.
Mm.
What if Pepsi was pronounced Peepsy? Wouldn't that just change everything?
Like, they just release a complete, like you go back in all of the Pepsi commercial catalogs, and they never actually said Pepsi. And then they release a commercial tomorrow that's just like, an ice cold Peepsy. And everyone's like, wait.
whoa, what? And try Diet Peepsy.
Clay Aiken, Sea of Fire. Now I know what he's been doing for the past 6 years. Ever since he got second on American Idol.
Oh my god, dude. That was really fucking out of nowhere.
Fucking
Peepsy. Or Dr. Peeper. Oh, yeah, the Rick and Morty things.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
Hey, Morty.
Yeah. Morty, you gotta watch out, Morty. Ah, jeez.
Ah, jeez, Morty.
Oh, my hair is all spiked.
The timeline is destroyed, Morty.
Ah, no.
Morty.
It's so funny, because did we talk about our buddy Justin? He, yes. He does that show, and, like, we asked him to do the voices. Forgive me if I've said this already. And, even when you watch the voices come out of him, you can't believe it's really happening.
Yeah.
You know? It's like, no, your human vocal cords cannot make such a beautiful dulcet tone.
Such a cartoony sound.
Yeah, it's really amazing.
It's just because you associate it with it, right? Like, if he just made some other voice, you'd be like, oh, okay, I can see
Yeah,
that.
You're probably right.
But if you watched a television show of that voice for a season and a half...
Yeah, it makes sense. Wait, is there an extra half a season that I've never seen?
No, it was just...
Don't fucking cock-tease me, Broseph.
Yeah, I mean, whatever... Season 2's coming out soon, I mean...
You know, hashtag stoked.
Hashtag super stoked. Hashtag, TiVoing it.
Yeah.
On my Samsung DVR.
Hashtag so jelly!
Do you ever notice that?
What's that?
Do you ever notice how we still call it TiVoing, but nobody actually uses a TiVo?
Oh, yeah.
They use, like, non-brand DVRs.
Yeah. And we say Xerox, even though, like... It's all just printed out and just copied another
copied.
Way.
Copied.
Yeah.
Just paper copied. And there's no word for that.
Nope.
Paper copied.
That is supposedly like one of the greatest keys to business. If you,
Like a Band-Aid?
Yeah, Band-Aid. Like if you have a product that becomes so synonymous with what it is that people call it the product name instead of the...
But that's the thing, right? Like TiVo is, like, went under. Even though people still call it TiVoing.
That's true. That's true. But I mean, like, a lot of people won't say soda, they'll just say a Coke. You know, can I get a Coke at a restaurant or something like that? Like, that's an insane amount of power in the marketplace.
You know what I've always wondered? Like, what if like, Coke or, like, a huge company like that...
was pronounced Kake?
What if Dr. Peeper...
Dr. Peeper!
...just didn't advertise...
Forgot about that one.
...for, like, two or three years? Like, what would happen? Like, something major like Coke.
I don't know.
Like, do you think they would just, like, fall off the face of the earth, or would it just be, like...
I don't know.
Like, sales would sort of drop, or, like, nothing would change?
First of all, I don't know if you could even do that, because, like, there's such huge companies with so many, like, shareholders and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think...
I'm just saying, hypothetically.
Oh, yeah, I have no idea.
Yeah, me neither. I always think about that. I actually think about that weirdly more than...
Than you should.
Yeah. Because who the fuck gives a shit about Coke's advertising campaign?
And, friggin'... They took us to Salt and Straw, which is an amazing ice cream place that has all kinds of weird flavors. They have, like, turkey flavor for Thanksgiving and all kinds of madness.
Help me!
Gotcha. And...
Oh my god, it can throw you around?
Yeah, it just tosses you around.
Help me.
Yeah, okay.
I think you're the only thing that can help me from that.
Yeah, I got him. I got him now.
Yay.
The heck was I gonna say? Sorry.
You're talking about the Salt and Straw with the
crazy lady. Yeah. So we're just like, this place is hugely popular. So like, it's got a line around the block, and you got to wait all day. But like, it's super worth it. And while we were waiting online, a woman drove up to us. How would you describe this woman's car, Aaron?
The car of a crazy person.
Yeah, that's what it was. And
it was insane.
Yeah. It had like a ton of trophies like glued to the front hood.
Yeah, like a chessboard of trophies.
Yeah. And a megaphone attached to the top of the car, and that she was using like an old school, like dialing phone receiver as like the walkie-talkie part for it.
The dog bone receiver.
Yes, it was super strange. And she was just like, you people are waiting for ice cream. You know that ice cream is the food of the devil or the food of Satan. And we were like, we did not know that. Did you know that?
Yeah, of course.
You fucking knew that and you didn't tell me?
Well, I mean...
Irresponsible, Aaron.
Well, it doesn't even matter.
It does.
Do you care about what Satan thinks?
Yes.
You should not care what anybody thinks in this world,
Look,
Dan.
I want to impress him.
Yeah, but like we were joking that when she left, we were just like, well, she just wanted the line to thin out. She could get her own ice cream.
I bet that's right.
Well, I try to imagine like what is her ideal situation in that? Like what does she hope to gain?
Just that people like. Turn their fucking ice cream cones down like Roman emperors giving the thumbs down in the Colosseum and just drop that shit.
And they're like, whoa, shit, I had no idea. And we all just disperse.
Yeah.
Like when you like stomp on an ant in a trail and then they're just like,
yeah. The owner of the store is just like putting sprinkles on a cone and it's just like, my God. She's right.
I had no idea. Shut it down! They just put the shutters down and people are like stuck underneath the shutters and go, ah!
Satan, we shall not be your vessel any longer!
Maybe it's because I always had a gag in my mind when that stuff happened.
Mm-hmm.
Like even as a kid. When like it would be like, ha ha ha, and the credits roll and I just imagine like what happened afterwards.
Right, right.
Just kind of like...
Well...
it's good to laugh together with you guys.
Yeah.
It was real fun. Scooby-Doo sure is wacky.
That's a great, like, that's from Anchorman. That's a really fucking funny line where they're like laughing together like that. And then like Ron Burgundy's like, laughter, we are sharing it. Couple of friends together. And they're like, Ron, you really ruin the moment when you do that.
That's how it feels, man.
Yeah. But like you hear it in children's stories too, like Happily Ever After, like... And you just assume, like, yeah, they're happy, the fucking everything worked out. Like, Disney shit, like, it's all got that feeling to it. Like, do you really want to see the Little Mermaid all bloated after menopause and... That came out way weirder than I meant it to.
Prince Eric's all pissed off because his mortgage payments didn't go through on
time. Yeah, he's like, geez, you were hotter when you were like 16 and an underage mermaid.
She was an underage mermaid.
Yeah, she's really young in that
movie. Oh, that's gross.
Yeah, the feelings I had are become less and less appropriate with every year. Ooh, you know you want that dog.
Get that dog. Check that shit. Got the dog.
I want that cake!
What is that from?
Fucking Nicolas Cage.
Oh, yeah! What's that cake?
What is Harry Partridge doing? I've never met him.
He's a good guy.
I'm sure he's cool, and like...
He's very smart.
And I haven't seen any stuff from him in a long time.
He's always working on stuff. He's got his own series, Starbarians, that's really, it's like a stream project.
Does he still do that?
Yeah. I mean,
I love it.
He's always working on it. It's a lot of work to do that kind of show.
I'm sure.
So, I think he might be doing the Patreon thing, I'm not sure.
Cool.
But a lot of the old Newgrounds guys are doing that now, because Lord knows YouTube hasn't made it viable to do animation.
Okay.
High five.
One more time. Let's do it. Let's finish him. Quickly. That's fucking what I'm talking about. Oh, so good.
Yes! Final smash.
Yeah, Howard Cosell had the same thing. He used to say, like... He used to refer to, like, his kids and, like, football players when he was calling a game as little monkeys.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But, like, white players and stuff. But then he did it with a black player, just not thinking. He was just, like, an out-of-touch older guy. And it, like, of course, ruined his career.
Wow.
Yeah. Aww.
Oh, it was his mother.
She was possessed.
Sister, I guess.
Oh, that's why it was so sad when she slapped her away.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow, jeez!
Yeah. Weren't ready for my gross scrotum, were you? I'm in Technicolor.
Don't run me through the wash. I'll ruin all your clothes.
Joseph in the amazing Technicolor ball bag.
Oh, now she's got to go. She's got to wiggle her butt a little bit.
I do very much like that, like, there's no,
dialogue?
Yeah. They just say it with... They show you instead of telling you.
It's the best way to do it.
Yep.
Always the best way. Oh.
Ooh.
That's messing with my steeds.
Yeah. Well, obviously, you just added another 30 seconds onto this playthrough. 30 seconds that I don't have to spare, bro.
Did I tell you that Umatani, our director, sometimes, he directed Table Flip and stuff. Anyway.
Yeah, and NSP videos.
And NSP videos.
Yeah.
Did I tell you that he...
Does he say Steez?
Yeah, he says Steez.
Yeah, I've heard him say Steez,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, and I was like, did you get that from Dan?
I'm very excited about that. I'm hoping he did. Yeah, I mean, I did not create the word.
But it's like a Jersey thing, right?
It's definitely an East Coast thing.
Yeah, because I don't think he's East Coast.
It's a combination of style and ease.
Oh, really?
Yes.
My Steez.
Yeah, girl. Messing with my Steez. Whoops.
I've only ever heard you say it, although it sounds like a thing that should exist, you know what I mean?
It frankly, like, the reason I say it is because it sounds like a thing that black people would say, and therefore it makes me sound cooler when I say it.
That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
God, they have some cool phrases.
Dude, they got the fucking monopoly on cool. We should do an antitrust against them.
Yeah, yeah.
Just because, like, you're too cool!
Yeah.
Why can't we be cool? We had James Dean.
Yeah. The court will now hear the case of Hansen and Avedon versus black people for being too cool and not leaving any cool for the rest of us.
Mother Ucker.
Too many Mother Uckers ucking with my shit.
Oh, did you see that?
That was really good. It was really good. But I don't want you to get cocky. Stay frosty, kid.
Is that...
It's from Aliens.
Oh.
It's a combination of aliens and Star Wars. Okay.
Oh, what the hell?
Whoa.
What the hell?
What?
Oh my god. Yeah, he goes for it. He just fucking goes for it when I have the last one. Boom, 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 boom!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah! Oh! Wow! Great fucking job.
Oh, jeez. Round two.
Yeah, exactly. Now I can show you my true form.
Yeah, that couldn't have been his last form. That was way too hard for that.
Where's my sister? Oh, there she is.
You always were the skinny one.
It looks like Here's your star I just made just now. I could have done that before, but whatever. Now you really earned it.
Lucky Charms!
Mmm, delicious. Painted with a sugar coating.
Kirby's like, yay! I might have diabetes.
Oh my god.
Sweet, we did it. We beat Kirby.
Is that it?
I think so. Yeah.
Oh my god, we did!
Jeez.
Wow!
Congratulations, us.
We beat fucking Kirby and Bloodborne on the same day.
Yeah. We
sure
did.
That's crazy.
Tadashi, kawaii!
Oh, so kawaii. Yay. Into the skull of despair.
Now, is it
round
two?
Yay! Yay!
Color again.
Yeah. Everyone's like, color! Horrible color!
To everyone playing black and white, they're like, I don't get it. What's so magical about
this? Oh, that's nice. I liked the plot / non-plot of this game. It was really good.
Well, that's all you need, right? It's like, something's wrong. When you do something, it'll fix it at the end.
We never figured out what the hell to do with the books.
Oh.
We just got it, and it was like, alright.
True that.
Oh, well.
Well, maybe there's a thing. You cleared story mode. Now you get level... Okay, so...
Ooh, and boss figurines. You got the very last page of the diary. Oh, it's a diary.
Secret diary.
Let's read the ending of it.
And they all lived happily ever after.
Yeah.
All's well that ends well.
Aww.
Yay.
Aww.
Yay for happy endings.
We should have totally been getting these the entire time.
Yeah.
But we just needed to have those extra 48 lives, just in case.
Yeah, just in case. Well, the last level was pretty hard, I gotta admit.
It was tricky.
Well, does this satiate your need for a happy ending? Well, I guess...
You know what?
Shit.
This might come out
this
long before Bloodborne.
Before Bloodborne.
I don't know. It's good. Who knows? It
yet.
Could be anything.
That's crazy.
Woo!
Next time on Game Grumps.
Yeah. This was a fun one. What a nice little game.
Yeah, it's cute, right?
It made me feel really good inside.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
I'll make you feel really good inside.
Whoa, okay. Catch you later, everybody.